Hi, I'm Chip Ritter, and I'm here to teach you the stick trick I call the garden weasel. The garden weasel, it's called the garden weasel because if you do two of them interlacing, it looks like a garden weasel that slices, dices, and mulches your lawn. It's a fun trick that stays in your hand and a great way to spin your stick around from the butt to the tip. The first step to doing the garden weasel is a trick called the finger flip. I'm gonna hold the stick up like this with my first finger and my thumb, pull my other fingers back. This is gonna give us room to let the stick move. Then I'm gonna put my second finger under it and let go of my thumb to let the stick come down around. It's coming down to the next finger, my third finger, which grabs it and then lets the stick go all the way around. And the trick here is the finger flip. We're gonna grab it with our finger, and as soon as we have it with that first finger again, we're gonna flip it into our grip, pulling the finger away. You wanna learn this trick first in order to do the garden weasel. First finger, let go of the thumb, second finger, third finger, all the way around, grab it with the first finger, and flip it into your grip. It's also useful if you throw your stick up in the air and you catch it with the butt up forward to just do a finger flip and you're back to the tip. Okay, I'm gonna show you this trick with my left hand. First, you grab it with the first finger and your thumb, pull your fingers out of the way to let the stick move. We're gonna take our second finger, our middle finger, and let go of the thumb to let the stick come down. Then I'm gonna let the stick proceed down in the same direction, grab it with my third finger while I let go with my first, bringing the stick all the way back up. And the trick here is to grab it with my first finger again and then pull it into my grip, moving my finger back around. First finger in the thumb, fingers away from the drumstick. Let go of the thumb with the second finger, the middle finger. Then we're gonna go to the third finger, let go with the first, keep going around and then grab it with the first, pulling our first out of the way. Don't worry if you drop it. I drop them all the time. First finger, thumb away. Third finger, grab it, pull it in. The finger flip. The next step to the garden weasel, because we're gonna be doing two pivots, we're gonna have to learn how to pivot between both. It's just like the fakie spin, but these pivots are happening more on the outside of our fingers, between the middle knuckle and the tip of your finger. So to do this dual pivot, which ultimately is the garden weasel, we're gonna have to practice each of them. So first off, let's do the live long and prosper. Hold it at the edge of your fingers like this. And then we're gonna try to do a fakie in this direction. Once we can do a fakie with this direction, I want you to pull your pinky in and do this. Again, with my left hand, I'm gonna do the live long and prosper. Put the stick in there, right around here, and I'm gonna try to get this stick to come backwards like this in a pivot. Then I'm gonna pull my pinky in and try the pivot again. This is going to be the first part of the garden weasel where we pivot. The next step is to try the pivot on the other fingers here. So we're gonna take our first two fingers, all our fingers are out, and we're gonna try to pivot backwards like this. It's okay to move your hand as long as once you get the pivot going, you can keep your fingers relatively stable. Then, once you can do that, pull both of your fingers in. See if you can pivot this way. It doesn't have to be graceful, just get the pivot going. Again, we're going to take the first two fingers with all of our fingers out and we're going to pivot back towards us. Just get the pivot going as good as you can. Then we're gonna try to pull both fingers down and try this pivot. Ultimately, we're gonna end up with two pivots that go back and forth. So now that we've got the live long and prosper spin, pull the pinky in, then we have the first two fingers spin, pull the pinky and the next finger in. Once we have that, we're gonna try to seesaw it between our fingers. So take a finger flip with the first finger of the thumb, pull the fingers back, second finger, let go of the thumb, now the third finger, and stop there. We're gonna take our drumstick, first finger of the thumb, second finger, let it come down, and then grab it with that next finger. Take the first finger of the thumb, second finger, then the middle finger, and grab it there. From there, we're gonna try to go back and forth. It's not that easy, but you wanna try to practice just seesawing the drumstick. I'm gonna start with my first finger and thumb, pull the fingers back, second finger, third finger, and we're gonna try to seesaw. We go back and forth. You could practice like this too, whatever's more comfortable. But once we have that seesaw, we're gonna go faster and start to try to pivot, swing it out in a pivot. Swing it out in a pivot. So we're gonna try to go pivot with the prosper fingers, prosper two fingers, prosper two fingers, prosper two fingers, back and forth until we can pivot back and forth. We're gonna take this seesawing motion. I'm gonna, first thing is I'm gonna kick it back with my prosper. Then I'm gonna catch it with the two fingers. Prosper two fingers, prosper two fingers. In a seesawing motion, I'm gonna try to do a dual pivot. Ultimately, that is the garden weasel spin. I'm gonna go through the prosper spin, then this two fingers. Prosper, two fingers, using the seesaw motion. Now I have a dual pivot. I work on that in an even way, and now I've got a good multi-angle pivot. It looks pretty good from almost any angle. The next step is dismount, or getting out of it. So we're gonna take our dual pivot and go over and over and over, and then we're gonna let the stick flip back into our hand with the exit move of the finger flip when we first did that. Pivot, pivot, flip back in. Pivot, pivot, flip back in. Pivot, pivot, flip back in. Now you can do one of two things. You can get out of it the same way, like a finger flip. You'll notice that it starts with the tip out. I do a finger flip, and now I have the butt out. With the garden weasel, you can do the same thing. Start with the tip out, and you have the butt out, or you can come around when you get out of it like this. It's more like one of those Blackwell spins. Letting the stick travel all the way around, then I can start with the tip out and end with the tip out. If I want to try to dismount it like this, I can do the finger flip, which takes it from the tip to the butt and just come into my grip. Or I can go all the way around so that I start with the tip out and then I end with the tip out like this. Twisting my wrist a little bit enables the stick to go all the way around, which is useful if I start with the tip up. I can come like that, or if I start with the butt out, I could just dismount it. Butt, tip. Butt, tip, all the way around. All the way around. Obviously, this is gonna take some time for anyone to learn. It took me a good while to get this dual pivot going. But if you're having any trouble, make sure you watch this video again and follow each step. If you follow these steps, you'll eventually be able to do this spin. And it's a great spin to use. So remember, the finger flip. Then we're gonna try to do the spin between our live long and prosper. You wanna practice that. Then you wanna practice the two fingers. And then you wanna practice seesawing. Get all of those steps together first, then you can put them together in a pivot that goes back and forth. It may take some time, but if you watch the video again, you'll be able to do it. Thanks so much for watching, and don't forget, there's loads of more videos just like this on Drumeo.com.